Welcome back to the Dr. G Aspie Show. I am Dr. G here at Southeast Psych, and normally I talk a lot about Asperger's, and today I'm going to do Parenting 101. This is going to be a general conversation about parenting, and I want to show you guys what I do in my office. And the principles of parenting for me is to be warm and authoritative. Catch your child making good choices three times more often than you catch them making bad choices. But the second part is you're the boss. You're the parent. And this little boys and little girls need to be listening to you, because when they know you're in charge in a warm and healthy way, then their anxiety goes down and they feel safe and comfortable. So to start off, we're going to do a little role play. And I'm going to show you guys kind of what I do in my office. And welcome, Sara Caitlyn.
Hello.
This is Sara Caitlyn. Sara Caitlyn is the Assistant Director of Communications and Projects here at Southeast Psych. Does a lot of our Twitter stuff and blogs. Super awesome. High five. Okay. So, Sara Caitlyn is essentially a nondescript little girl who's come to my office, and your parents want some help parenting you because you're kind of Miss Bossy Britches. All right?
Okay.
So, I start with a foundation with the client because I want to incorporate children into the session, and the parents are observing this interaction. Hi.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm good.
We're going to play a little game.
Okay.
It's called Big Girl, Little Girl.
Okay.
Sara Caitlyn, are you a big girl?
I'm a big girl.
Yes, you are. What do big girls watch on TV?
Disney Channel, mm-hmm. Discovery Channel.
Discovery. Yes, you're a smart big girl.
Yes.
What do little girls watch on TV?
Blue's Clues, Dora mm-hmm. the Explorer.
And a little bit of Barney.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Do big girls play outside?
Yes.
Do little girls?
No.
Well, they can, but only if mom and dad are real close to them. Okay?
Right.
Do big girls go to the movies?
Yes.
Okay. Little girls?
No.
Not so much, because they're long and they get all antsy. Do big girls get to play on iPhones and video games?
Yes.
Little girls?
No.
No. Very good. When do big girls go to bed at night?
9.
Yes. Sometimes 9:30. When do little girls go to bed?
7.
Or 6:30.
6:30.
Yes. Not so fun, huh? Okay. So this is the difference between big girl, little girl. But let me ask you this. Do big girls put their towels away and hang them up after shower?
Yes.
Do little girls?
No.
No. They need a lot of reminders.
Mm-hmm.
Do big girls talk back to their parents?
No.
Do little girls?
Yes.
Do you?
No. Sometimes.
Sometimes. So sometimes Sara Caitlyn makes big girl choices, and sometimes she makes little girl choices. But she's here at my office because lately you've been making lots of the little girl choices. Okay? High five. Thank you very much. So Sara Caitlyn shows how I build a foundation with the client. Now the parents observe this, and then I teach them three strategies I use to help teach a child that mom and dad are the boss, but you do it in a warm way. And the hardest part of this is consistency and keeping low emotion. You don't yell and nag and kind of freak out about stuff. So what I say to Sara Caitlyn and her parents is, I don't nag, yell, lecture, repeat myself, threaten, take things away, send them to their rooms, mainly. I don't do any of this. And usually the child looks at the parent and says, see, this guy knows what he's talking about. And then I ask the child, well, if you make a poor choice, then what should happen? And everybody kind of looks around the room because they don't know. And what I encourage parents to do is three things. And they're all based on the idea of, I don't want to say restitution, but putting energy back into the system. If I send a child to their room, they're just going to the room. They're going to wait me out. Maybe they'll be up there in the room yelling and screaming. But nothing really happens. So I use timeout for kids basically age 2 to 12. I use stares, and I'll get to that in a minute. And I also use chores. And here's what this means. If I send a child to timeout, they need to go to the timeout spot, sit quietly, and the timeout doesn't count until they've been quiet for whatever time I think is reasonable, which can be anywhere from 2 to 5 minutes. It's not a big deal. But the child has to, again, demonstrate effort and show self-control by staying quiet in the corner. After it's over, they apologize, big hug, go on about your day. The second is stairs. I have kids go up and down staircase. So if Sara Caitlyn makes a bad choice, I can say, you know what? I've warned you about this enough. go on and give me 15 flights of stairs. That means up and down 15 times. It's showing effort. It doesn't count until it's done quietly and appropriately. You don't add stairs, it's just 15 flights. They can yell at you. You don't keep pounding on or piling on consequences. The third is chores. These aren't unloading dishwashers. This is, I'm going to Windex the windows, or I'm going to have a kid wash a car or clean out garbage cans. Something that's not fun and is a little bit unusual and, again, requires effort. When the consequence is paid for, they apologize, name the behavior they did, parents hug, say, I forgive you, it's all over, you go on about the day. I tell Sarah Caitlin, or my clients, you can say no to your parents. You can. You can say, no, I'm not going to do it. And then that child is grounded. Grounded until they're 18 years old, or until the chore is completed, or the stairs, or the timeout, or usually the chores or stairs. And then the child looks at me and says, well, I didn't think you put grounded people. And I said, I didn't. You did. You can either choose to do the chore, or you can be grounded, one or the other. And then I ask parents just to wait the child out until the consequence is done. And then the child feels silly if they've stayed grounded for a couple days, because all they had to do was 15 flights of stairs. And that's a little boy or a little girl who thinks they're in charge. And when parents take control back in a warm, authoritative way, not cold, authoritarian, you do what I say because I said so. This is a warm, authoritative way of parenting that brings the child into the equation. Their anxiety goes down, the behaviors improve, the parents feel successful, and it's just a better way of living. And hopefully your grandchildren will be parented the same way, and you won't see this cycle of yelling and screaming and fighting just get repeated generation after generation. Resources I recommend, I really only recommend two or three books, and one is 1-2-3 Magic, which is great for how to do timeout ages 2 to 12. I also recommend Monty Roberts' book, Horse Sense for People, and also Parenting with Love and Logic. Those are three books I use. I really don't do much with charts and star charts and all that stuff because I'm not very good with that. But this philosophy of parents being warm and in charge and setting appropriate limits, but including the child, typically can do a lot of good for my families. Again, not all interventions work with each kid, so consult with your local social worker, psychologist, therapist. They can help guide you through this. These professionals are invaluable. Seek them out and get your kid under control. I'm Dr. G. Thanks for tuning in to the Aspie Show with Parenting 101. You can find more online at southeastpsych.com, and you can follow me on Twitter at Dr. F. Gaskill. And remember, Asperger's is awesome.